Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lyco Birds with another video in my Bird ID Through the Year series, and this is going to be the first of several videos in a row talking about duck identification, and this one is going to be about male dabbling ducks. This is sort of easy mode for duck identification because the male plumages are so distinctive, but this really helps lay the groundwork for being able to identify the females, which more people struggle with. And this is going to focus on birds on the water, not in flight. Ducks in flight will likely be another several videos later on in the series. And we'll get this one out of the way first. I think almost everybody is familiar with mallards, with their green heads and brown chests separated by a white ring. They also have yellow bills and a pale body. And the tail is white with dark above and below it. You may also be familiar with the incredible range of plumage variation that mallards can get with domestic influence. And if you're not familiar with that, I would recommend maybe searching for Mankey mallards or domestic mallards and just taking a look at some of the example photos in case you run across those birds. Next up is another species that we talked about in a previous video, American black duck. And these are a very similar shape to mallards, and overall they look like a dark version of a female mallard. And male American black ducks have yellow on the bills. And unlike the other species we're going to talk about, female American black ducks actually look almost identical to the males other than the bill color. If you're having trouble distinguishing these from female mallards, one other thing you can look for is a dark tail, because female mallards have white in the tail. So let's move on to some species that we haven't covered yet in this series, and the first of these will be gadwall. And male gadwalls are generally gray and brownish, kind of gray in the sides and then on top, and then the head is more of the brown color. And then towards the rear, it's mostly black. A lot of times you'll also see a white patch in the wings. And something that's very helpful on these is the head shape. So you can see it's almost like a square shape with rounded corners. So you have this very tall forehead and then sort of a flat top of the head and then a somewhat flat rear to the head, and you kind of complete the square. And that head shape can help us when we start trying to identify the females. So overall, the plumage on male gadwall is fairly understated, but also sort of distinguished. Next up is northern pintail, and these are quite elegant looking overall with their long necks and their long tails. And also with the way the bill kind of transitions into the head, just gives it a very elegant look overall. And in terms of colors, it has a brown head and a gray bill with white on the front here and then sort of gray sides that transitions then to that long tail. And again, it's these structural things that you want to keep in mind for when we're trying to identify the females, because the male plumages are not very difficult, but you want to look beyond the plumage, which really can help you out when you're trying to identify the females. Next up is American Wigeon. And on these, the overall color of the body is this sort of pinkish color, or some people have told me they don't see this as pink, but they see it more as like burnt orange, or if you want to say more of like a salmon color, however you see it. We don't necessarily have to agree on the specific names of all the colors as long as you can identify them. And then towards the rear of the body, you see the back here is black, and then they have this white hip patch. And a lot of times you'll also see this white stripe here where the body meets the wings. And in terms of the head, you can see they have this small kind of bluish gray bill with a black tip. And then they also have a green patch that kind of runs behind the eye, white on the forehead. And then most of the time, the cheek is just sort of this brown color, but there is also a variation called storm wigeon that you can see here on these two birds. And that's when the entire cheek area is that same color as the forehead is on normal birds. and that is a pretty uncommon thing to see. You'll also want to keep an eye out for Wigeons that instead of the pinkish color, they have more of gray sides, and instead of the brown and green head, they have more of red on the head, and that would be Eurasian Wigeons. And those are rare, but pretty much expected now in the Northeast. And just to clarify, Eurasian Wigeon is a separate species, and Storm Wigeon is the colloquial nickname for the plumage variation of American Wigeon with the white on the cheeks. Then we have Northern Shoveler, and these have extremely large bills even compared to the other ducks. And in terms of plumage, they have a dark head, and then they have this rufous patch in the flanks that continues under onto the belly, and then in front of that and behind it, there is white. And the combination of all those things gives these a very distinctive look. Next, we have one of my personal favorites, blue-winged teal. And these have sort of this textured tan color in the sides and this small white patch at the hip. And then the facial pattern is what is really distinctive on these. They have sort of a dark gray head and a really dark bill, but then they have this bright white crescent towards the front of the face. And one thing to be careful of is that some of the female diving ducks do have white in this area of the face as well. So don't assume that just because a duck has some white in this area that it's a blue-winged teal. And then we have our other teal, green-winged teal. And these are small and compact ducks with sort of a red and green facial pattern. And on the sides, you can see this gray textured pattern, and at a distance that just becomes sort of gray, but then they have this buffy patch towards the tail. And the thing that really stands out is that they have this vertical white bar. And I should note that instead of the vertical white bar on the Eurasian form, which is called common teal, you see they have this sort of horizontal white stripe instead. And some authorities treat common teal as a distinct species, and some don't. In North America, typically we consider both of these to be green-winged teals. And I'm not sure that these are always considered to be dabbling ducks. They're more in the perching ducks, but it makes sense to treat them in the dabbling ducks. This is wood duck, and these are extremely distinctive looking, particularly the males. They have a very unique head shape with sort of this crest that hangs off the back of the head. They also have a red bill and just this very intricate plumage with a lot of green in the head, and then you can see some red, some tan. You have this nice white bridle here under the neck. And wood ducks like to perch in trees a lot, and they'll also be found in wetlands, and they sort of tuck in, so a lot of times you don't really see them until you end up flushing them because you got too close. So that wraps up male dabbling ducks. And these aren't too bad, but next time we will take a look at female dabbling ducks, which I know a lot of people struggle with. So make sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss that next video. Also consider signing up for my email list at lycobirds.com/email. There's a daily ID quiz in that and anything else that we publish. It's free and easy to unsubscribe at any time. And I hope to see you next time. Thanks for watching.